epic 360 jump shot, right? I will teach you how to do all that. Hey, what's up everybody? It's your boy Hugh here from Creator Up. Today, we are going to do an in-depth technical review of the Insta360 OneArt Invisible 360 Drone Mod for Mavic Pro 2. We will examine the Insta360 OneArt Aerial Edition in terms of stabilization quality, stitching quality, and post-production cost saving. We will find out who should get this and who should not. And if you decided to go for it, I will show you how to set it up and how to use the Insta360 stitching technology to get the best result. This video will include the software portion of the workflow to explain everything you need to know, how easy to stitch out the drone in both mobile app and desktop app, which is one of the advantages of this setup. Invisible 360 drone tech is not new. I have been doing that professionally for the past 5 years, way before Insta360 OneArt or OneX even exist. And as always, I will cut through the marketing hype and explain everything in depth, provide comparison and alternative solution to help you design your future drone investment, both in knowledge and hardware investment. Who should buy this Invisible 360 drone mod? Almost 99% of the reviewers right now of this camera are not 360 content creators. They only know how to use this camera as a reframe 2D camera, which is totally fine. Reframe, also known as overcapture or free capture, is to film in 360 and point your camera in post-production with apps or plugins. The end result is still a flat 2D video. If you are only going to use this drone mod as a reframe camera and try to copy some of the cinematic FPV drone movements, then this mod is probably not for you. You should really learn how to fly a real FPV drone instead. As a matter of fact, you actually need FPV flying skills to operate this, at least for Mavic Pro 2. More on that later. So to bust the bubble, I want to be real to you right now before you buy, so you don't get disappointed when this 360 drone mod does not live up to your expectations. If you want to create 360 immersive content like what you saw on my channel, where you cannot find the drone in the 360 video, and you want to fly indoor, then this is a great investment. One of my recent 360 videos got selected by Forbes as one of the top 25 VR videos of 2019, link right here. This immersive 360 video opens with an invisible drone shot that gives people the illusion of flying above Sao Paulo City. This is captured 5 months ago before Insta360 OneArt release. So yes, you can create the same result without the OneArt invisible drone. We will compare this two method in this video. Flying without GPS, Eddie mode. As a responsible YouTuber, your safety is my first concern. I don't want you to take my advice and then crash your drone with your expensive new camera system. And you will if you don't watch this part carefully. When you fly with the Mavic Pro 2 Insta360 OneArt Aerial Edition, it blocks the GPS sensor, and your drone will switch on Eddie mode, or altitude mode. When in Eddie mode, the following safety features will be turned off: return to home, obstacle avoidance, and GPS location. You need to understand the following dangers of flying in this mode. Your drone is more likely to crash if you are a beginner, never fly or practice in Eddie mode. If a fly away happens, the drone will not return to its original takeoff points. Make sure to keep it within range so the signal between you and your drone is strong. There is drift happen and your drone will move on its own if you not remain still in the air. Your hand have to be constantly adjusting the control to keep your drone stable against wind.
Ooh. Ooh. Shit.
You have to fly within the line of sight and be alert of your environment, like birds and people. Use the DJI official controller instead of your phone or iPad for a stronger signal and better control, as you are now a real pilot. If you are aware of the above warnings, fly according to my instruction, which is fly within the line of sight, use an official remote to avoid fly away, and never take your hands off your controller, then flying in airy mode is actually lots of fun and very necessary for 360 drone operation. You might think that, well, I will just wait for the Mavic Pro 1 version to have a full GPS signal. But GPS is actually the reason why your movement will be jerky for 360 videos, and you still cannot fly indoor or on a boat where GPS is actually work against you. So, in short, if you want to capture good 360 video or cinematic FPV drone shot like what you saw on the Insta360 commercials with this mod, you need to learn how to fly in airy mode and fly like an FPV pilot. Setup and installation. After the safety warning, let me quickly show you what is coming with this kit. The 360 drone kit comes with a different 360 lens system. It's not like the Twin Edition, which is an all-in-one unit. The unit can be separated into two independent lens modules. This will be the same module used on your VR180 setup. So if you intend to use Insta360 ONE R as a VR180 camera or 360 drones, don't buy the Twin Edition. Buy the VR180 or Drone Edition instead. It will save you some money, as the Drone and VR180 Edition lens module can be combined and used as a regular 360 camera like so. So, another unique thing about the 360 drone mod compared to Twin Edition is how the battery can be positioned vertically. This is actually a request from some of my viewers to have a vertical camera setup instead of a boxy camera setup like the Twin Edition right here. As you see, 1R now kinda look like 1X. Now, let's get out of the studio and get some hands-on. We will assemble the 360 drone in the field. So now we're gonna assemble the drone with the brand new 1R attachment to make it into a 360 drone. Let's do it. So I put all my equipment right here. You see right here, let's see what we have. We have a charging USB cable. We have a top part of the mount right here. See right here. We have the bottom part of the mount right here. And in here, we have the camera unit. We have the little control unit, the core display unit. And then with the bracket, we have two GoPro style mount right here. And then lastly, we have the battery unit right here. So a lot of moving pieces. So it's actually not that hard to assemble it. Simple is actually very easy. So first, let's put the mount together. So instead of putting the top part first, I would suggest actually put the bottom part first. The bottom part just slap on. So you flip that right here. If you see right here, this is the hook area and hook straight to the drone in the bottom section. So you just need to hook it and push it in and over lock in, see? So we lock in, easy. Go ahead and flip it. And also the trick is, I will also move the bottom leg of the drone, like so. So I can put the drone right there on the ground. So if you need some leverage. So then we gotta attach the top part. So the top part is here. So right here, so go into right here, the drone, the wing of the drone. So you go ahead and align them. If you push it, it snap on. So you snap on. The other side. You push it in.
You snap on, you hear a snap sound. You snap on, it's really easy. So now, the mount is attached. So see, you can actually, like, using the mount to hold the entire drone up. So the second part is put the camera in. So go ahead and see this camera. This is a camera unit. So one thing about VR camera, right? Even your lens protector, you see this kind of dirty lens. So I always have a lens pen with me. Right here, I have a lens pen with me. So before I put the thing onto the drone, I always go ahead. To clean the drone. To clean the lens right here. And then make sure you have no dust. See this part is separated. So this is the unit that is different from your regular unit. So that is designed for the drone mount and the VR180 mount. So actually there's a top. So I already labeled them top and bottom right here. So I will teach you in the other tutorial how to find out which one is the top, which one is the bottom. But when you order this, this should come with the label. So you know exactly which one to put in the top, which one put in the bottom. Very important, don't swap them. If you swap them, your video will be upside down. So go ahead, this is the top part. So go ahead and put in the top part. Just slide in, and it's in. And I will leave the bottom part last. The second thing I put on is the core unit. The core unit is also very easy. Make sure the LED screen, you see here? Make sure the LED screen on the other side, right here. Just slide in, push it in, and it connect to the mount. And then you flip on the other side. See, this is the battery unit, have a two USB. One USB here, one USB here, USB-C here. You can just generally put it in right here and go right in. So here's the blanket, the last part. I found it easier is actually get the battery unit out first and actually put in the battery unit from a USB-C, connect the USB-C on the mounting blanket. Just push it in for now. Like that, make it snug. And then the whole thing slide in. The center, so see here, there's a T right here to lock into this little space right here. So to make sure this part is firmly attached to the mount. So you can just slide the battery unit and this thing together, level. And then if you see this other side right here. So this part connect to the USB charging power of the core unit. So make sure this align. Sorry, make sure align. Just push it in. It. Okay, so that is pretty much it. Last part is you flip the drone like so and put the last part of the lens right here. Slide it into the drone. Again, the whole process, make sure your hand is not touching the lens so you're not leaving any like finger mark on your camera, on your lens. That will make the footage look bad. So make sure that if that's happened, again, use the pen to clean it. So make sure that there's no dust on the lens. Okay, so one last part, so you need to secure because you have no idea what's on the air. So you want to make sure the mount is firmly secured onto the drone body. So I also will put in the GoPro mount right here. So when you're not flying this entire unit, the way to put it down is put the leg like so, fold it back halfway, and then if you can gently put it on the ground, see the lens is not touching the ground. So this unit is safe.
On part 2 of this series, we will compare OneR Aerial Edition with my other professional 360 drone setup, also using OneR but the Twin Edition, so you can better understand the advantage of using OneR Aerial Edition.
in terms of post-production cost saving. We will compare stabilization performance and discover potential problems and solutions to avoid the jello effects caused by the rolling shutter. We will measure the stitching distance of 1R aerial addition, so you can fly with confidence to know your subject is not in the stitch line or be cut in half like what you see in my head right here. Part 2 is a must watch if you are considering getting the Mavic Pro 2 or Pro 1 1R Aerial Edition. Click the next video right here and watch it now.